teaching them. So this one is going to be a more advanced flow, just because I'm not going to be talking you through all variations and modifications, so it's a bit more flowing and less chat from me. So do listen to your body, and feel free to visit any other videos if this one isn't quite right for where you're at with your yoga practice. But enjoy. So onto your mat, grounding through the feet. We're gonna inhale, lengthen hands high. And exhale, swing the arms low. Two more, inhale high. Exhale low. And again, inhale high. Exhale, hands low. This time, hands sweep forward. Inhale, mini back bend. Exhale, half fold. Option up onto toes. So I'm not going to cue you as much through the breath, so I want you to focus on steady in-breaths, out-breaths. I'm really connecting with that. Softening the ankles. Inhale, mini back bend. Exhale, half fold, option heels. Keeping heels off, coming into chair. Inhale, sweeping high. Option still to keep the heels up. Exhale, half fold. And exhale to your chair. Wrapping your heels. Full fold from here. Release the head. Inhale, lengthen, look forward. Grounding through the hands, right leg, stride it back. Left leg, coming back for your plank. Pressing weight forward and rolling back. And again. One more. Connect with that breath here. Spread the hands, press the floor away. Taking this a downward facing dog, so press bottom high. Paddle out. Right leg, lengthen up. Bending through the knee, try and sneak the knee higher. Bringing that knee up to your right elbow. Press it back. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Left side, inhale, lengthen. Soften through the knee. Inhale, press forward, knee to elbow. Press it back. And again. One more. We ground through the foot. Walking feet into hands. Center of your mat. Raggy doll. Wiggling these feet wide. Toes on the angle, sitting back, Malasana. Grounding through right hand, pressing the right knee out, lengthen through left.
topping sides. Round in through both hands. Release the heels. Forward fold. Feel free to have a little wriggle. Right hand, centre of mat. Soften right knee, lengthen left hammock. Circle it down and swapping over. Once more each side. Walking the hands forward. Taking a little hop back to your plank. Exhale. Hover to the off the floor, come to the floor. Inhale. Press to cobra or up dog, thighs up. Exhale, press to your downward facing dog. Right leg, knee into chest, press it forward. High lunge. Grounding through left hand. Rotate. Option to stay here or go onto the outside border of that back foot and press side plank. You can keep foot low or press up to your star. We're going to stride that right leg forward, coming back to our high lunge. Reversing our lunge, left hand comes down the leg, reach up. Connect with that breath. Windmilling the hands, come back to your plank. Exhale, lower and hover or to the floor. Inhale. Up double cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left leg, stride it in. High lunge. Grounding right hand, left lengthens high. Stay in there or turn to the outside border of that back foot and press. Side plank or take it, press through the floor to your star. Left leg strided forward, return, high lunge. Reground through the hands, stride it back, exhale, Chaturanga, inhale, up double cobra, exhale, downward facing dog. A couple of paddles out here. To fallen star. So we'll go right leg first. So you're pressing your weight forward. Ground through the back foot and open up for fallen star. So right leg spread under, left hand comes high. Taking the hand back down. Back to downward facing dog, left side. So press weight forward, weave left leg through, open through the right. So we're going to go again, and you've got the option of taking that leg off the floor, keeping it off the floor. So right leg, knee to chest, ground through the back foot, and lengthen up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left side, knee to chest, press forward, weave it through, but on the floor still, or hover up. Exhale, downward facing dog. We're going to walk the hands to the feet. Stay low. And release your head. and look forward. Inhale, come back to Tadasana. And slow. Take a stride into the middle of your mat, getting the legs a little warmer. Now, feet hip width or close together, your choice. Exhale, come to your chair. Take whatever hand option you want. Option, heels off. We're grounding through the heels if they're off. They come into eagle, try not to lengthen up as you come into it. Challenge. So you're wrapping right leg over left. You can stay with prayer arms or you can take eagle arms. So right hand comes over left and we wrap round. And then aim to lift elbows higher. We're going to come to warrior three to release this. So you can take whatever hand option you want. Pressing single leg to Tadasana. So lift it up. And ground through the feet. Back to your chair. Option heels up. Through the heels, eagle with the left. So feed it over and wrap it round. Staying with prayer hands or taking to eagle, so left hand over right this time. And then lengthen, elbows high. Warrior three. Single leg mountain. Press tall. We ground through that left foot, striding front of mat, sense meditation A. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, step or jump. Carry on that exhale to Chaturanga. Inhale. Up double cobra. And exhale. Downward facing dog. Couple of extra breaths here. Inhale, step or jump, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, rise it up. Exhale, hands low. Coming back into chair. Release the left heel. Hover that foot off, stride it back. High lunge. So this time ground through the right hand onto the outside of your right foot. Lengthen left hand up. We're going to come drop that back knee and then reverse our lunge. So sweep right hand up. Coming back forward.
take pressure off the back knee. We're going to turn the foot out and sweep over to Skandasana. So you're coming low. Hands can be down for support or into prayer. From here, we're going to come to seated. And I know I'm facing away from you, but this means you should see it first, the correct way around. So you're seated down on mat. We're going to inhale, hands high. And exhale, feet over to your right foot. Try and keep ground through the left. Coming back up, left hand behind left bum. Pressed hips up. Lift and open through the chest. Sweep it back round. And release the feet, press it back forward. And stride it in. Lengthen, look forward. Inhale, rise it up. Exhale, chair. Right heel release. Stride it back. High lunge. So left hand this time. Left hand low on the outside of the left foot. Reaching up with the right. Grounding back through the back knee. Inhale, left hand high. Reverse your low lunge. Inhale, come out of this. Pressure off that back knee. We're going to twist over. You're facing away from me now. But right knee is bent. So hands on the floor for support, or you can take them off into prayer. And then bring yourself down to seated. Inhale, lengthen hands high. And exhale, fold over to that left foot. Inhale back up, and you're going to press yourself forward to the front of your mat again, and full fold. From here, grounding through the hands. We're going to stride back with left foot this time. So left foot comes back. Coming up onto fingertips. Or hover up, so press the floor away through that front leg and hover. Staying here or add load. So tension through fingertips through to the back heel. We ground it through the hands. Going to turn onto the outside border of that left foot, and you're going to release your right hand and circle it down towards the back foot. So you can lower bottom down high if that's okay in that front hip. And inhale, come back forward. Exhale again. Inhale. One more. Exhale. Inhale. We ground through the hands. We're going to come to plank and just swap our legs straight over. So you're plank and stretch left leg forward. Hover the hands or press the floor away.
so that left leg is working harder. So in here, or add that lengthen. Right hand comes low, turning onto the outside border of that right foot, sweeping left hand up and over. Inhale, come back forward. Exhale. Inhale. One more, exhale. Inhale, we ground through the hand, press it back, downward facing dog. Coming to wild thing. So we'll go left leg first. So left leg, lengthen up, bend through the knee. So you're open through the hip. You can hover up here or ground the foot to the floor. Press the hips up high. Sweep it back, downward facing dog. Right side, lengthen leg, bend through the knees, open through that hip. You can hold it here, or carry on the foot to the floor, press hips up. Take it back, downward facing dog. Challenging these arms a little bit here, making sure your fingers are truly spread and sharing the load. Think about drawing elbows into one another and softening through the elbows. You should feel activity around the shoulder blades working now. Press back to your downward facing dog. And again. Lowering down to your dolphin now. So you're coming down onto those forearms. Still press the floor away and lift bum up high. So you can stay here or keep thinking, pressing the floor away so head never comes into contact with the floor. You can walk feet in. Maybe lengthen one up, touch it back down, other leg, touch it back down, walking the feet out, coming to low plank, to wiggle forward on the mat, I'm out of mat. So keep pressing the floor away through the forearms and check you're not bum up in the air somewhere, but you're in control. We're going to tap both knees down. Press away, and again, and press away, three more, and press, touch down, press the heels away, lost count, one more, and press, walking, knees in, knees wide, press back, child's pose. Coming up on all fours. Press the floor away through the hands and let the shoulders just dip. And again, press, let it dip. Bring the ribs in, so arch it up, let them sink down. And again. And then whole spine, so press the floor away, lift the ribs, tuck tailbone under, for your cat, and then cow, for your cow.
And again. One more. Travel it this time. So press bottom back, roll it up and round. Ripple it round again. And from here, coming up high kneel. Coming to camel. So this one will give you a few options because we're coming into a back bend. So you can keep hands onto lower back and tuck toes and just think about pressing hips forward, lifting through the chest. So you might be here, you might be able to take hands down to calves, or if you've got more range, flattening those feet. But your focus is on pressing those hips forward. To come out of this, soften through the knees, release one side. Coming back to your cat-cow and ripple again, travel it through. And then stay in your cat, so you'll stay pressed away. And then just shift weight forward and back, but keep in your cat. So don't lose that arch. Best as you press back, keep that arch. From here, tucking the toes, walk the hands forward, downward facing dog. Being really solid through your hands and your feet. So you're pressing the floor away through the hands. Think about sending the sit bone high. And your legs are strong. You might want to take just a slight step in with this one because we're going to keep about focus on keeping square. But we're going to take that right hand off, lengthen it up past the bottom. We ground through the hand, left side, stay square. We ground through the hand. Inhale up onto tiptoes, ripple forward. Knees down. Press it back, child pose. Give those wrists a wiggle. Coming round to sit on to your bottom now. We're going to come back into boat. So you're up on your sit bone and roll off just slightly and stay, I think, lifted through the chest. We're going to hover off and lower, other side, or you can hover both off. We're tapping one down and up, other side. Couple more. And then crossing over on the knees. Inhale, shrugging shoulders up. Exhale, release. Two more. Keeping that focus on your breath now. Deepen that in-breath, slower in-breath, directing it down to the belly, ribcage. out, everything just melts back down. Just choose a positive mantra for your day, or I'm doing this in the morning, so I'm setting a mantra for the day. If you're choosing to do this in the evening, it might be that you do a mantra for letting something go for the day, or something you've taken from the day. So for your next 5 breaths, repeat that mantra on your out breath. Regular breathing. Inhale, lengthen hands high. Exhale, hands to prayer or heart center, and forward fold. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope having the mic is of benefit to you as well, so you don't feel like I'm shouting at you. But thanks for joining, and I'll be back with